Hi, I'm Patu from freefincal, and today let's take a look at Franklin India Savings Fund. Who should invest in this fund, when to and how to use this fund, and what kind of fund this is. So before we begin, yesterday I talked about parenting challenges with regard to planning for their future college education, maybe even marriage. I had started a poll. So far we've had 282 responses. And it'll be nice if we can have at least 300 responses. Then I'll be able to have some kind of representative sample set. So I have the link in the description box as well as in the first comment. Please take a few minutes. It's an anonymous poll. It's an yes or no poll. It'll just take a couple of. It'll take less than a minute for you to fill. So this is what is known as a money market mutual fund. A money market mutual fund, or rather the money market, is a particular sub-segment of the bond market. And here people deal in very short duration bonds, from 1 day to a few months. And this fund can invest in bonds up to 1 year. And in this segment, liquidity is more important than anything else, and therefore it's a very liquid funds are money market funds, the overnight funds are money market funds, ultra short term funds are money market funds, and also of course there is a separate category called money market funds, although it's a bit of an overkill in my opinion. These are also a variant of an ultra short term fund also. So Franklin Savings is a fund is a very different kind of fund in the Franklin universe. It doesn't take on credit risk like its other funds. I have recommended as part of my plumb line for investment durations of 1 year and above, and I'll explain that. It was started in 11th February 2002. It was a floating rate mutual fund then. In a floating rate mutual fund, the interest given will change as per the rate movements, but the value of the bond will not change much. Therefore, the interest rate fluctuations of the NAV will not be much. But since June 2018, because of the SEBI categorization and so on, this fund changed from a floating rate fund to a money market fund. So I have several basic details here. You can read the review post for the full details. So first, let's have a look at the kind of bonds that it invests in. It has a history of investing in the financial sector and also in bank certificates of deposits, which is basically a tradable fixed deposit. And even before, when there was a floating rate fund as well as a money market fund, it generally has this kind of a tendency. And if you look at the money market segment today, typically the fund, the primary holdings of the fund are in bank and finance sector, and that is true of the other, in general, of the category as well. And if you look at the kind of bonds that it buys, before it was a money market fund, it used to dabble quite a bit in corporate debt. But then since May 2018 or June 2018, it has moved over to certificate of deposits primarily, and commercial paper from essentially what do you call the non-banking financial corporations and so on, the financial sector. And if you look at the rating history, it used to have quite a bit of AA bonds and so on when it was a floating rate fund. But since then, it has moved on to become the dominant holding is a short-term A1 plus bond. A1 is for short-term bonds. A1 is the same as AAA rating. And A1 plus, A1 minus, A1, those are three grades. So it sticks to that those three grades since it has become a money market fund. And if you look at the maturity profile of the fund, earlier it used to have 1 to 3 year bonds, but after it became a money market fund, it primarily invests in short-term bonds up to 12 months. Unfortunately, even though many of its bond has got a duration of more than 1 month, if you actually look at the Franklin website, they will tell you, they have a video and they will tell you the recommended or the ideal investment horizon is more than 1 month. Please don't follow that. Please don't follow this advice from any AMC. Everyone is wrong, because if you have a look at the rolling returns, 1 month rolling returns, you can see how volatile it is. And compared to that, the orange is just a liquid fund. So if you want 1 month, if you want to hold your money for 1 month, use an overnight fund or a liquid fund. do not choose an ultra short term fund, money market fund, or short duration fund, because the return volatility will be too much. Of course, if you increase it from to 1 month return, to 6 month return, to 12 month return, and so on, the ups and downs will die down. And only when the ups and downs have died down, you should use a particular fund. I will do a very detailed video on how this changes from one category to other, and when I'll talk about when to use what mutual fund. But this is with respect to Franklin Savings. So finally, who should invest in this Franklin Savings Fund, and how it can be used in several ways. If you are a first-time debt mutual fund investor, and if you want a little more return than liquid funds, and if you have a duration more than 1 year away, you can invest in this. You can use it for short-term goals. You can start an SIP in this fund, like an RD. You can use it for long-term goals, but that would be a bit too conservative. But yes, if you're worried about credit risk, yes, this is a good fund to hold on. If you have some lump sum that you want to invest in the equity market, if you have booked some profit and you're looking to re-enter back and so on, that kind of thing, this fund can work because it doesn't have an exit load, I think. Yes, it doesn't have an exit load, so it works. It would be beneficial for those in the 30% slab to use the dividend reinvestment option if you are in profit booking and so on. Then there'll be a marginal benefit compared to actual paying as per slab for periods less than 3 years. You can also use it for deriving monthly income via a systematic withdrawal plan, but you must be careful. There are risks involved because it is investing in a majority of the bonds are there in the financial sector, the non-banking financial sectors. If there's a crisis in that sector and there's a domino effect and so on, then this fund will also get affected. It was holding Dewan Housing Finance bonds, but it exited at the right time, so it did not get affected. As I could not find any credit risk problem for this fund, or even a credit bond rating downgrade also or upgrade, I did not find for this fund. So it's very, in that sense, it has a good history. Over the long term, it will give you more than a liquid fund, probably comparable to an FD, or maybe at times a little bit more than an FD. But if you take into account tax, it's definitely more tax efficient than an FD. So it's up to you whether you want to take on this kind of market risk over the long term. I think it's okay to take that risk and go ahead and invest in a debt fund of this kind. You must be careful about the interest rate fluctuations. The interest rate fluctuations will be low because the bond duration is only a few months, up to 1 year, 12 months maximum. The credit profile is also reasonably good. Therefore, it's a good balance, but you have to be aware of the risks nonetheless. So thank you. I'll catch you again later. Please fill the poll. Thank you. Bye.